All right, so let's pull all this together and look at an example of something that was really hard to do before and is now shockingly easy with dynamic parallelism. So if you remember from one of your earlier lectures, Quicksort is what's called a divide and conquer algorithm. It works by partitioning an array of data into two pieces, partitioning based on what's less than or greater than a pivot value. You then call Quicksort on each subpartition, which is why it's a recursive algorithm. These subpartitions then get repartitioned over and over again recursively, and so you end up at the end with single values, and you're done. Two important things to notice are first that the subpartitions aren't usually the same size, and second that some branches go deeper than others. This means that the number of elements to be sorted is different each time, and so the decision on whether I need to subsort can only be made after I've done the partitioning. That's what makes it hard to implement on a GPU, because after each step, I need to communicate back to the host CPU all the information about what I want to launch next. That's a lot of communication at each level of the algorithm, and it gets pretty complicated to manage. But even worse, I end up launching each stage of the sort as a wave of kernels. As these things partition down further and further, the number of kernels that I have to launch gets larger and larger, and the only way to manage them is to launch them wave after wave. What that means is that I end up waiting as long as the longest operation in a wave, even if my shorter ones have already finished, before I can move on to the next stage.